Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that indeed man is in a loss if Ramadan comes and goes without him being forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a beautiful hadith. Indeed, Ramadan is a month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardons his slaves. The gates of Jannah open and the gates of hellfire are closed. So what loss are we in if we are not amongst those who are forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is indeed a blessing that in this month we find ourselves free most of the time. During lunch breaks, most of us come out early from work or schools and we find ourselves seated free doing nothing. It is said that most of us waste this time in watching movies, series, going out, seated outside doing nothing, playing. Let us try to utilize this time, this very short period of time of 30 days only, to gain the blessings of Allah and to achieve His mercy. Let us try and utilize this time in doing a lot of istighfar and tawbah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us try to and maintain azkar most of the time, whether we are in school, whether we are in the offices doing nothing. Most of the time, we indulge in ourselves with vain talks with our colleagues or friends. Let us use this time to do azkar. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, whoever says subhanallah bihamdi 100 times a day, then all his sins will be forgiven, even if they're like the foam of the sea. Let us also try to get into the practice of saying Sayyid Istighfar in the morning and in the evening, because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that whoever seeks Istighfar through Sayyid Istighfar and he dies during the day, then he will be amongst those on the paradise. And whoever says it in the evening and dies at night, then he will be amongst those who will be in Jannah. Lastly, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that if any Muslim greets his fellow Muslim, feeds his fellow Muslim who are hungry, maintains ties of kinship, and prays at night while all the others are asleep, then indeed he will be admitted into paradise without being punished in the grave or in the akhirah. Subhanallah, look at how beautiful this hadith is. Look at how merciful Allah is. Just these four things, let us try and practice them in this month of Ramadan. Wallahi, because we will be in a great loss if we will not be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine all the sins you've committed in these 11 months. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses you with this 1 month to achieve His blessings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closes gates of hellfire. Allah opens the doors of Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, no matter what sin you have done. Always be hopeful in the mercy of Allah. And as you are hopeful in the mercy of Allah, then let us try and remember Him most of the time, saying Astaghfirullah, Subhanallah, bihamdi, Subhanallah al-Azim, most of the time. Let us seek tawbah through salah. When you are done with salah, seek tawbah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because wallahi, we never know when we are going to depart from this world. Lastly but not the least, this is not an advice only to those who have sinned, but it is an advice first for myself and then to you. Never despair from the mercy of Allah. No matter how much you have sinned, no matter how much wrong you have done, because wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to gain anything by punishing you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to forgive His servants. The paradise of Allah is so wide and open to any Muslim. So do not despair in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.